For a seemingly friendly TV personality, Rachael Ray attracts a lot of negative attention, especially from fellow celebrity chefs and food writers. For one reason or another, the following folks just can't stand Rachael Ray. Not good enough for Martha. The queen of homemakers, Martha Stewart, expressed her skepticism of Rachael Ray's skills in a not-so-flattering way in 2009. Stewart revealed in an interview with ABC News that Ray once admitted to her that she couldn't bake. Exposing that weakness on national TV was bad enough, but Stewart kept throwing her trademark brand of subtle shade.
She just did a new cookbook, which is just a re-edit of a lot of her old recipes, and that's not good enough for me.
Stewart went on to say that Ray is more of an entertainer than a teacher. Stewart defused the situation not long after with an apology to Ray on her show. And Ray told ABC News that, ultimately, Martha had a point.
When it comes to producing a beautiful, perfect, high-quality meal, I'd rather eat Martha's than mine, too.
Too amateur for Emeril. Emeril Lagasse eventually got over his tiff with Rachael Ray, but for a while, it looked like they were going to be lifelong enemies. According to journalist Alan Salkin's 2013 Food Network tell-all From Scratch, Lagasse once said Ray, quote, doesn't know anything about food, and even said if it was his call to make, she never would have been on TV.
I love that little thin, pretty little...
Now!
The two seemed to patch things up, though. Or maybe Lagasse just realized that publicly berating a popular figure wasn't the best way to revive his then-waning career. Regardless, Lagasse went on to become a frequent, chummy guest on Ray's show.
Salt for the taters.
Oh, those look so good, Rach.
Not gelling with Giada. While Giada De Laurentiis has officially denied rumors of a feud with Ray, if you read between the lines, it seems likely that there's at least a little bit of bad blood between them. In 2009, De Laurentiis tried to squash rumors of a feud in Redbook, but her attempt to put out the fire was less than convincing. Giada admitted in the magazine, "Do we hang out all the time? No. Are we best friends? No." The two went head-to-head on Iron Chef America in 2006, and De Laurentiis, who was teamed up with Bobby Flay, doesn't seem to have gotten over losing to Ray and Mario Batali. In 2014, she told Hamptons magazine how annoying it was that people still asked her how she felt about losing to Ray. "It will bother me until the day I die. I'm a fighter and I like to win. I'm not a good loser." Too brash for Bourdain. The late Anthony Bourdain was never known for holding back his true feelings, and he had an intense dislike of Rachael Ray. In a now-deleted 2007 guest post on author Michael Ruhlman's blog, Bourdain wrote, "Complain all you want about Rachael Ray. It's like railing against the pounding surf. She only grows stronger and more powerful. Her ear-shattering tones louder and louder. We know she can't cook. She shrewdly tells us so. She's selling us satisfaction. The smug reassurance that mediocrity is quite enough." Bourdain portrayed Ray as a sort of anti-Julia Child, who, rather than enlightening aspiring home chefs and inspiring them to cook better food, she, quote, uses her strange and terrible powers to narcotize her public.
Let's say that's perfect, shall we?
Not subtle enough for Sarah. Sarah Dickerman, a former chef, cookbook author, and food writer at Slate, called out Ray in 2005 while discussing the sorry state of culinary TV. In a takedown of All Things Food Network, she singled Ray out as the most problematic celebrity chef, writing, "Worst of all, there are endless hours of Rachael Ray, who dines out on the cheap and cooks on the fly, chirpily renouncing such culinary values as elegance, subtlety, and perhaps even flavor. It is enough to make you give up on TV cooking shows."
And we have our... We'll get that later!